Buried in the depths of this tropical rainforest is a cave called Cueva de Villaluz. Located in southern Mexico, it's an underground world laced with hydrogen sulfide, a foul-smelling gas that was present on Earth some 4 billion years ago.
These relic or antique environments like Cueva de Villaluz offer the same kinds of environments that we would have found on early Earth, and we're hoping to get clues to work backwards from those. As you approach the cave, you begin to get these faint whiffs of the rotten egg smell. And as you get closer, this becomes more intense.
Hydrogen sulfide can be extremely poisonous. So the scientists have to wear gas masks inside the cave and carefully test them for leaks.
No leaks. Have you got everything in there?
I think I got everything.
At the levels at which humans can't live very long in hydrogen sulfide, you don't smell it at all. It would just simply cause you to go unconscious and die very quickly.
But can any other forms of life survive in the deep recesses of the cave, so toxic to humans? Here, hydrogen sulfide, an invisible gas, escapes from the underground springs, reacts with oxygen in the water, and coats the cave with sulfuric acid.
The longer it sits there on the walls, the more acid it becomes. And so eventually, by the time the drop is falling on you, it's a very, very acid environment.
The slime layer feels pretty thick today.
It's very fatiguing, and even with the protective masks that we have, we pick up loads of toxic gas through our skins and perhaps through tiny leaks.
Oh, get away with those sweat tights to your left.
Amazingly, despite the extreme conditions, it appears that life is thriving inside the cave. It comes in a strange package, colonies of single-celled bacteria that form slimy drips scientists call snotites.
The snotites are drippy, gooey, mucousy formations that look like stalactites, and that's why they were called snotites, but because they resemble strings of snot. We believe that the snotty, gooey stuff is to protect them against the extreme acidity, because when we measure the drips on the snotites, they are as extreme as battery acid. And so while we find that daunting, this is where they thrive.
Bacteria are among the most primitive and most common organisms on Earth. Like all forms of life, they grow, adapt to their environment, and reproduce. Inside each single-celled bacterium is a molecule of DNA, the code of life, which allows them to multiply. There are millions of bacteria in each snotite. And down in the underground streams, Penny Boston has found different kinds of bacteria in slimy clumps she calls phlegm balls. In fact, the cave is home to a huge number of bacterial colonies. And astonishingly, instead of being poisoned by the hydrogen sulfide, these bacteria depend on it for their survival.
They take the hydrogen sulfide and they get chemical energy out of it. It doesn't poison them. It's home sweet home for them. And this is a pretty new finding for these organisms.
Conditions on early Earth may have been far worse, but these bacteria suggest that primitive life could have thrived in extremely hostile environments.